Hi, Mission Springs community. It's Lori Short. And I know you are probably not where you thought you'd be this summer because none of us are where we thought we'd be this summer. This has been quite an amazing year. And Chuck has asked a few of us if we'd be willing to share an encouraging word, kind of a way to bring camp to you since Mission Springs isn't having their normal program. And I've been thinking back on the events of the last several months, starting with the coronavirus that had us all in our homes under lockdown. And then just as we were beginning to emerge, this racial devastation that happened that I think has caused us all to think and pray and listen in new ways. And just looking at what God has been teaching us and the circumstances that He's allowed into our lives so that we were positioned to maybe listen and see things in a new way, some things that He wanted to show us. And so the word that I want to share with you actually comes from Philippians. It's a verse that I included in a book that I wrote since I was with you, because I was with you 2 years ago. It was called 40 Verses to Ignite Your Faith. And this one verse just stood out to me. And it's when Paul was in prison, and he says this: "Now I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has served to advance the gospel." This is Philippians 1, verse 12. And I think about Paul in prison, probably somewhere he didn't think he'd be, didn't want to be. I think about all of us having been in lockdown and now still not really able to live our lives the way we want to. Everything is different than we thought it would be. And yet Paul had the wherewithal to look around at his circumstances and say, "I want you to know that what has happened to me has served to advance the gospel." And what Paul knew is that because he was in prison, other people were speaking on his behalf. They were sharing the gospel. And he was encouraged by that. And I was thinking about us in lockdown and the ways that God moved. For instance, moving the church out of its buildings and into our homes and onto the internet and into the ears of so many more people that have been listening and hearing the gospel that maybe never would have come to church. And so I am mindful of how God has been using this season. And then also positioning us so that when all of this occurred, these deaths that happened, these three deaths, and then culminating, of course, with George Floyd, that was the tipping point that caused us all to just rise up and say, "No, no more." And so in some ways, our circumstances positioned us so that we were ready for this justice cry that I think all of us have right now. And so perhaps we can learn from Paul saying, "Now I want you to know that what has happened to me, these small little sacrifices that all of us have made, and some I know have made bigger ones financially, some people have lost jobs, income, there's been a lot of loss. But to be able to say what has happened to us has served to advance the gospel, so in that way we can rejoice, just like Paul did when he was in prison." But the second part that is so, I think, so important about this verse is that Paul looked around and said, "Okay, so what can I do? You know, I can't do what I thought I'd be doing, which was evangelizing churches. So you know what? I think I'll just write some letters. Now that I'm in prison and I have this time, I'm going to write letters that will encourage the churches." And what Paul could not have seen is what God was going to do with those letters. Because if Paul hadn't been to prison and written those letters, we wouldn't have half the New Testament. And so I think about Paul's words, "What has happened to me has served to advance the gospel." Paul didn't even know the power of his words, because prison is what gave Paul the circumstances to impact so many more people than he would have had he not gone to prison. And so maybe that's a word to us, even this summer, as we are home, or not doing the trips and the things that we thought we would do, to look around and say, "Lord, what do you have for us?" And for many of us right now in this season, that means listening and learning from voices that maybe we haven't learned from before. Maybe it means being intentional about a friendship or building a bridge or maybe reconnecting with someone that you know of a different race, of a different color than you, and reaching out to them and saying, how can I hear you in a new way? How can I be a friend to you? Or maybe it's even coming together with people and doing a Bible study. I know I created 3 video studies this summer because all of my speaking engagements got canceled. And I'm hoping that those video studies will be used between people, maybe diverse people that can come together and talk about these issues. They're on waiting, fear, and hope. Those are universal human issues that perhaps 2 people could come together of a different race and talk about these issues and hear the stories from each other. And that God would use this time to unify the church, because I believe that's his heart. We can be so different in so many ways, but when Jesus brings people together, when we come around that common gospel, when we become the church, we are all different colors and all different races, and we bring all of that, but we are unified in Christ. And I believe that that's what he is speaking to the church, to rise up, to speak for the people that have been oppressed, to unify with people that are outside your normal circles, and to be the church. And so I hope that this is a time when we can maybe do some things that we wouldn't have done if we had our normal summer. And I know you are missing Mission Springs, and hopefully in another year you'll be back there. But I would encourage you to have the spirit of Paul and to look around and see what God might want to do with you where you are.